Now, you do have critics calling this president as traveling too much, his eighth trip in 7 months. Do you agree with that?
I agree. I think he has been traveling too frequently and in the face of several problems in the country that we are experiencing.
Okay, but then the president has also said that it's his way of selling the country to other nations for foreign investors to come in. What do you think of that? I mean, you do have the former president Duterte, who some have said have been quite abrasive with the United States at one point, with the European Union at one point. Doesn't this benefit the country that President Marcos Jr. is actually perceived to be liked by world leaders, that he is Western educated, that he is the country's best salesman?
Well, to some extent it is true, but from another angle, it also looks like he's hard selling the Philippines, hard selling the Philippines too much.
Okay, so what makes you say, when is it hard selling?
Well, when you keep repeating what you have said before, what you have mentioned before regarding the need for investments from other countries, then that is a hard selling. I mean, that is not going to be effective because maybe some countries will be turned off by too much pushing for what it wants.
And does it even work in the World Economic Forum? Is that our audience? Professor, I wanted to ask you, I mean, have you ever been to Davos at any point during your career in government?
No, I haven't
Okay.
because, yeah, no, I haven't.
All right. And the reason I'm asking this is there are conferences, there are trips that actually benefit a certain country because the investors are the market for that country. Do you believe that the World Economic Forum is even our market?
Well, the Philippines, I think, is a market for all regions of the world, including those who go to the Davos regularly. I think during the time of Gloria Macapagal Arroyo and also when Pinoy went to the Davos, I do not recall any positive fallout from those visits by those two leaders. But
Uh-oh.
those two leaders of ours.
Okay, what you're trying to say is they didn't need a particular businessman or a company coming from the World Economic Forum. Any of the attendees were in an actual investment was formed coming from the WEF.
Yes, because I think the World Economic Forum is really more of a acquaintance and getting to know each other. And finding out what might be further pursued in terms of negotiations regarding, say, investment or whatever a particular country needs.
Okay, now you were NEDA chief in the last administration, and some have said that the growth rate of countries, how inflation has affected many countries, could be one of the topics of the WEF. And this government has said they were expecting a growth rate of 6 to 7%, but the World Bank actually predicts 5.4%. HSBC predicts 4.4%. Then we have issues, the problems with onion prices and the prices of basic commodities. What do you believe has the president, what should he focus on instead of the WEF?
No, I think in many people's minds, I think the focus should be on addressing critical issues in our country. Mm-hmm. And well, traveling is fine, but 8 foreign trips in 7 months is kind of excessive, I think. And in the meantime, there is a lot of attention needed in our country. Skyrocketing prices of onions and meat, I think, also, and eggs is there going to be the next item that's going to see a surge in inflation in prices. So, and also, he has not even completed the cabinet. Mm-hmm. And in terms of the his previous appointments, many had to be replaced. So, all I'm saying is that his homework has not really been attended to.
Mm-mm, mm-mm. So why do you think is the president always traveling for you? Because you did say you feel it's too much. So why do you think is he doing this? What's the reason?
Well, I think he's trying to to change the perception of the Marcos years. Mm. Because the Marcos years is still people are still conscious. Other country leaders are still conscious of what happened during the Marcos years, martial law. So I guess he might be trying to recover, to remedy what the perception has been in the past, and maybe continuing to the present. Maybe there.
So, Professor, are you saying that you believe that the motivation, the underlying motivation, is really more personal in nature, to clear or cleanse one's name?
That could be one purpose, and I would not gainsay that he's not interested in really pushing the country's prosperity in terms of getting more foreign direct investments and trade and so on.